Singleton, Sullivan, Herrera. And Singleton, who has the longer black trunks there right of your screen, we heard in his corner trainer Rudrick Colbert telling him between rounds, get a little more aggressive now, is what he wants from him.
I don't see that really, Jim, because he's definitely behind the fight right now, and he's up to start getting away from him. And, I don't see him better, though. You know, he's going there over hand right, and Singleton's going under it. And I like seeing him turn the applicant and hang up every big shot from him. Because he is ducking into a shot, man. I think the uppercut will be effective for the right foot there.
It makes sense, and I think a lot of Barrera's previous opponents probably haven't made Barrera think that much. And, he's used to and accustomed to hitting people with the overhand right and then go to sleep. And he doesn't have to do that too much. And Singleton's definitely making him explore other options.
Barrera at 8-0 coming in. It's not a question, not that he has a probably a little better caliber of fighter. This is one of the tougher fighters he's fought as a professional.
Absolutely. Herrera's actually got a very strong resume. He's fought a guy named Willie Herring, a very tough journeyman type guy. Also another guy, Epifanio Mendoza, who fighters at 7-8 normally don't fight this early in their career. So he definitely has fought the better opposition.
A slip. Brad Talmadge, the referee, indicates that quickly as they resume action in round three.
Pedigree. He also fought, current world champion Chad Dawson in the 2001 junior world championship, and also defeated current WBA 175-pound champion Dave Schumann in 2002 in the world championships as well. So this guy's been good for a long time.
Inadvertent below the belt shot as Blair Talmadge goes to the corner, wants to make sure Barrera's okay. Now you look at it.
This is Singleton bringing that right up, go right underneath that cup. A very painful shot.
Up on his punches, and Singleton is almost ready to pull the trigger. It looks like ready, but never quite does.
Yes, it's a little bit too late there, and you just can't get the time to have to let him burn his punches.
Singleton's going to have a lot better success if he can start utilizing his jab. It's tough to fight a fighter like Barrera and not set anything up and just have success with big punches.
That was an awkward attempt at a right that almost knocked him off balance himself, but Singleton able to stand up, and Barrera continues to move along at a kind of a methodical pace here.
He does. He's really not the typical Cuban style we're used to. He is heavy-handed, though, and he looks to be setting up that right hand nicely in the second and third round.
Yeah, Singleton looks like he wants to counter punch him, man. You know, he tells him to fuck the fender rating that way. He does like the counter punch, but he's not effective with his hand. Do you